Pray for like you, Lord. Make me to rest soon, let me stand again. Make me to pray, let me stand right now. Emi adura wabale mi, wabale mi o.
Emi adura wabale mi.
Majekemi
ya ole, omi gbagbo.
Emi adura
wabale mi.
Ami yo.
Emi adura wabale mi.
Make me to pray more like you, Lord. Make me to pray all day and night. Make me to pray seriously, Lord. That is contrary to God, my Maker.
Pray and just claim your good promises. Make me to always trust in God. Make me never to fear the threatens of Satan. Make the spirit of boldness to always walk in me. That I will resist Satan with my prayer. I want to pray more like you, Lord. I want to
rest so more in prayer.
Make me to pray
more like you, Lord. Take me to rest so, let me start today.
Make me pray.
Make it
rain,
let it start right now.
Emi adura wabalemi, wabalemi.
Emi adura wabalemi.
Oh, majekemi ya ole, onibagbo emi.
Emi adura wabalemi.
Abi,
to never pray amiss. Make your word to fill my heart and guide my prayers. Make your name, Jesus Christ, to always go with my prayers, that you will always answer my prayers. I want to pray
more like you, Lord.
Pray more like you, Lord.
I want to
wrestle
my prayer.
Pray
more like you, Lord. Make me to wrestle, bend me down today. Let me stand right now.
I want to pray
God like you, Lord.
I want to wrestle
my prayer.
Let me to pray
God like you, Lord. Make me to wrestle, let me start to pray.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, everybody. May God bless you today. These days, because of the dual programs we are having, some very important announcements we are unable to make. Because we rush. Now, children, you are going to children church this morning to do your program. So all children age 12 and below begin to go to children church now. Now, I know the next question is, children worker, how do you do it? We need to work out how you come back to hear your own message. But for now, they have to go. So please, ushers, check among the congregation. Any child that is below 12 that is there, I mean below 13, I mean, should be released by the parents. If we need to call the children workers to come and carry them, please call them. Now, as I'm going to be preaching this morning, not one person should be at the biscuit joint or roaming about. Not one person. Not one. At the security point, we should have limited people there. Only those who are supposed to be there should be there. Any child that is not up to 13 should not remain inside. Once you are not up to 13, go to children's church. Quick. It's actually 13 and below. If you are not up to 13, start to go. Now, if you are hearing me outside, suspend whatever you are doing and come inside. You don't have this time to waste. Very, very important. You need to hear everything I will say from A to Z. If you miss one line, it will be too costly. Now, two more announcements. Youths, I'm begging you in the name of Jesus. Anything that will make you not to go for the neighborhood Sunday fellowship, don't allow anything to hold you down. We have prayed for you that nothing will hold you down this year. There is no vehicle to carry you. If elderly people trek and youth cannot trek, you'll be in trouble. That's number one. Number two, many of you are now becoming bench warmers. Bench warmers. If you are youth in this church, you are not playing any role. You are in serious trouble. Parents, you are hearing me. I don't have such a program. I don't have such a program that you come to church and sit down and relax and just hear. I told you I began to pastor a church. I wasn't an assistant pastor. I was pastoring a church far away from my district headquarters from age 25. That's when I began to pastor. Far away from my district headquarters. I was in Ikole Ekiti. My district headquarters was at Adu Ekiti. My district pastor visited me once in a blue moon. I don't have a fridge of once in 4 months. And I was doing it well. Some of you are now 25, 26. You come to church, you call yourself Omoede. And the world is seriously advancing, increasing. That was 1980. You are now in 2019. When everything has drastically advanced. And you come to church and just sit down and hear. In case you don't know, the blessings of believers and blessings and best womans are not the same. That is a quotable quote for you. Go and write it somewhere. The blessings of believers and blessings of best womans. I know some adults will not like to hear that. The blessings of best womans and the blessings of believers are not the same in church. I repeat, the blessings God releases to believers and the blessings he releases to bench warmers are not the same. When you come newly, you come like a bench woman. You are expected not to be a bench woman for too long. It's time for the message. Stand up and let us pray. Oh Lord of heaven and earth, there is none like you. You are our maker, our king, our Lord, our caretaker, our all in all, our yesterday, our today, our tomorrow. Thank you so much for your love, mercy, and goodness you are making us to enjoy. Thank you for today. Thank you for all you have prepared for us to enjoy in this house and also when we go out. Cause that blessing that you have prepared for each of us to be ease in Jesus' name, and cause that plan of the devil to rob us of your goodness and mercy to come to failure. Lord, you know the content of the message of today. You know it's a dangerous message because it can be easily misunderstood. I pray, oh Lord, that no one in this house hearing this message, no one online hearing this message, and no one will hear it through any other means in future will misunderstand the message. Cause everyone to fully understand your purpose for sending this message at this time, and cause each person to so understand to be able to play his part so that your perfect will be done. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I have a lengthy topic for the message. I try to make it shorter. I think I should have done that, but I didn't have enough time to really work on making it shorter. Meaning, as I preach, a shorter topic may come. You can even help me to manufacture a shorter topic for it. Meaning that tomorrow you may have a shorter topic at the back of the CD containing the message. Well, let me give you the elongated topic I have. The topic of a sermon. The topic of the sermon is a message of the sermon in the shortest way possible. So I'm preaching today about how to insulate your wife not to instigate you to do wrong.
Ìyàwó rẹ láti má ru ọ sókè láti
agbára ò sínú insulate o insulate ni rubber tan fi bo wire ko ma shock eyan toro lo university oni fagbara ko o ma mi ti bere nsi wa je kan be si foju buruku wo mi don't mind her. I never said fagbara ko. How to insulate your wife,
bi o se le fi isoso abi ki o daabogo,
not to instigate you to do wrong. The plan is to make sure your wife does not push you into wrongdoing. How do you go about doing that? You need to insulate your wife. When you see electric wire, there is a rubber covering the wire. That rubber is called insulator. That will not allow you to reach the live wire. When the insulator is open and the wire is exposed, anything can
happen.
In 1 Kings chapter 21, verse 25, You know that my time to preach these days is short. I told the coordinator, you better make your things quickly because I'm preaching 3 days sermon in one. This sermon is supposed to take 3 days. But I have sermons lined up that will not allow me to continue to preach. So I want to preach everything today. But it's supposed to cover, by the time I finish, you will see it's supposed to cover 3 days. I have so many Bible passages to read. Follow me. 1 Kings chapter 21, verse 25. But there was none like unto Ahab, which did sell himself to work wickedness in the sight of the Lord, whom Jezebel, his wife, stirred up.
Lati sise buburu niwaju Oluwa eni ti Jezebeli aya re nti sugbon ko si enikan bi Ahabu ti o ta ara re lati sise buburu niwaju Oluwa eni ti Jezebeli aya re nti.
Now youth that in the house,
bayi eyin odo to wa ninu ile,
you ask yourself,
e bi ara yin le,
what concerns me with this?
Oluwa kan mi pele yi o.
Is to prepare you for tomorrow. Youth in the house, you are going to hear something today that will benefit you all the remaining days of your life. When you become matured and married, this message will be ringing in your heart and it will assist you to enjoy the best of your marriages in the name of Jesus Christ. This is not a common sermon. Not even here. It's not something you can preach there and preach next week and preach next week. But you have this opportunity to hear it. The sermon I am preaching today is a dangerous one. Dangerous in the sense that it can be easily misunderstood. A sermon like this is better preached to an audience made up of only matured men.
Iru wasu bi eyi o san ju lati se wasu re kiki fun awon okunrin to dagba dada.
Not a mixed audience.
Ki san se awon eyan la ta
ko papo. Adults and youth, men and women like this. But I am preaching it to the whole congregation, because though it primarily focuses on men, it is for both men and women. Though it primarily focuses on adults, it will prepare children for a better tomorrow. Though on the surface it may look anti-women to some people, I'm not using it at all to castigate women or present them as bad or inferior. I am not castigating women. I can't do that. When I have, though I've lost my mother, I still have a lot of beloved women in my life. I have my wife. I have 2 daughters, biological. I have thousands of daughters, spiritual daughters. I have my sisters, both biological and spiritual. I have female members in Lagos and other parts of the world. In most cases, women are even the majority in the religious circle, of which Bible Pattern Church is not an exception. How then come that I will be castigating women, ridiculing them? That is not my purpose. That is not my intention. But this message may sound like that to some people. But you will discover at the end that I am 100% biblical in this preaching. Also, I am not about to use this message to encourage women that are doing wrong to continue to do wrong, or those who are doing well to copy those who are doing wrong in any way. Because doing wrong by either a man or a woman will surely bring serious consequences. In Hebrews chapter 2, verse 2, we are told that if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward. Did you hear that? All disobedience of the power received a just recompense of the word, recompense of reward, suggesting that the wrongdoings of today will also receive a just recompense of reward.
Nítorí bí ọ̀rọ̀ tí a ti ẹnu àwọn angẹ́lì sọ bá dúró ṣinṣin àti tí olúkúlùkù ìrékọjá àti àìgbọràn jágbọ́n yẹn bí ìrékọjá àti àìgbọràn sì gba ẹ̀sàn tí ó tọ́, ó túmọ̀ sí wípé àṣelòdì òní pẹ̀lú yóò gba ẹ̀sàn tí ó tọ́.
How shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him?
Àwa ò ti ṣe làá bí àwa kò bá náání irú ìgbàlà ńlá bí èyí tí a tètè kọ́ bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí sọ láti ọ̀dọ̀ Olúwa tí a sì ń fi múlẹ̀ wá láti ọ̀dọ̀ àwọn
ẹni. In Proverbs 11:21, it says, though hand join in hand, the wicked shall not be unpunished, but the seed of the righteous shall be delivered.
Nínú ìwé orí kọkànlá
11:21.
Ìwé orí kọkànlá ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkànléní ogún. O wípé bí a tilẹ̀ fi ọwọ́ so ọwọ́ ènìyàn búburú kì yóò lọ láì jìyà, ṣùgbọ́n irú ọmọ olódodo ni a ó gbàlà.
In Proverbs 16:5, say, everyone that is proud in heart is an abomination to the Lord, though hand join in hand, it shall not be unpunished.
Nínú ìwé orí kẹrìndínlógún ní ogún ẹsẹ̀ karùn-ún, olúkúlùkù ènìyàn tí ó gbéraga ni bí àyà. Ìwé òwe orí kẹrìndínlógún ní ogún ẹsẹ̀ karùn-ún, olúkúlùkù ènìyàn tí ó gbéraga lé àyà, ìdíra ni lójú Olúwa, bí a tilẹ̀ fi ọwọ́ so ọwọ́ yóò wà láì
jìyà. In Proverbs 17:5, whoso mocketh the poor reproacheth his maker, and he that is glad at calamity shall not be unpunished.
Nínú ìwé òwe orí kẹtàdínlógún ní ogún ẹsẹ̀ karùn-ún, ẹnikẹ́ni tí ó bá sin olùpọ́njú jẹ tó gan ẹlẹ́dàá rẹ̀, ẹnikẹ́ni tí ó bá sin olùpọ́njú jẹ ogun ẹlẹ́dàá rẹ̀, ẹni tí ó bá sì ń yọ sí wàhálà kì yóò wà ní àìjìyà.
And in Proverbs 19:5, a false witness shall not be unpunished, and he that speaketh lies shall not escape.
Orí kọkàndínní ogún ẹsẹ̀ karùn-ún, ẹlẹ́rìí èké kì yóò wà láìjìyà, àti ẹni tí ó sì ń ṣèké kì yóò mú un jẹ.
And in 19:5, it says, a false witness shall not be unpunished, and he that speaketh lies shall perish.
Ní ẹsẹ̀ karùn-ún yẹn orí kọkàndínlógún, ó ní ẹlẹ́rìí èké kì yóò wà láìjìyà, àti ẹni tí ó ń ṣèké kì yóò mú un jẹ.
In Proverbs 28:20, it says, a faithful man shall abound with blessing, but he that maketh haste to be rich shall not be innocent.
Orí kejìdínní ọgbọ̀n ẹsẹ̀ ogún, ó ní olóòótọ́ ènìyàn ni yóò pọ̀ fún ìbùkún, ṣùgbọ́n ẹni tí ó kánjú láti là kì yóò ṣe láìjìyà.
There are so many vices.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ọ̀nà ló wà.
Those first talk about.
Tí àwọn ẹsẹ̀ bíbélì wọ̀nyí.
That I would have needed to expatiate on.
Láti fẹ́ láti là ayé wa kedere.
But because of the shortness of my time.
Ṣùgbọ́n nítorí kúkúrú àkókò mi.
I want to summarize by saying.
Mo fẹ́ sọ àsọkágbá gbogbo rẹ̀ nípa sísọ
pé. There is no wrongdoing.
Kò sóhun ìṣèlódì
kankan. That anyone can indulge in.
Ẹnikẹ́ni lè fọwọ́ rẹ̀ sí.
There is no provision for reward.
Tí kò sí èrè ètò fún ẹ̀tọ́
rẹ̀. The other day I told you. There is no grace given to you to prevent you reaping what you sow. So what I am trying to do through this message is to let every husband know that women are configured by God differently from men. And therefore should not be expected to behave like men in any way. One of the greatest source of problems in the families today is the refusal to understand and appreciate this fact that a man is male and a woman is female.
And
there's no meeting point between the two. They are totally different from each other. Generally, women think, desire, behave, spend, etc. differently from men. Therefore, it is so easy for a man
to
fail through a woman, especially his wife. This should be one of the reasons effeminacy is condemned in the Bible. In 1 Corinthians 6:9, know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate. Nor abusers of themselves with mankind. If you read the rest, if you go to verse 10, it says they will not inherit the kingdom of God. If you go to English dictionary to look for the meaning of the definition of the word effeminate, it talks about a man who demonstrates the habits of a woman. I mean, to be an effeminate is for a man to behave as a woman. Listen very well. The Bible says a man that is an effeminate, meaning is a man behaving like a woman, will not inherit the kingdom of God. How serious is that? 1 Corinthians 6:9. All women in this house, you know. Any attempt you make to transform your husband, to convert your husband, to translate your husband to behave like you, is to prepare him to go to her. So he must not behave like me. He must never be like you. God deliberately make man, woman. This is important. I'm sure you've never heard it from me, but you're hearing it from me today. And you can see that I'm reading it from the Bible. We have this problem in 1 Kings chapter 21, verse 25, that I've read and I'm going to read again. But there was none like unto Ahab, which did sell himself to work wickedness in the sight of the Lord, whom Jezebel, his wife, steered up. Steered up there, he's talking about instigating, provoking, pushing, luring into something. So we are told that it was Jezebel, the wife of Ahab, that instigated him to do the terrible evils he did. Listen to me, women, men, children, adults, listen. In every generation, it is a common thing for wives to push their husbands into irreparable problems. Listen very well. I'm about to make a very serious statement. You must hear this. A woman doesn't have to be a bad woman to lead her husband into serious problems. Make no mistake about it. A woman does not necessarily need to be a bad woman to push her husband into serious problems. Both good and bad women are capable of doing this. Don't forget the topic. How to insulate not yourself. I know somebody will say, how to insulate yourself so that your wife does not push you into error. That's not my topic. If you did that one to yourself, it's your topic, not my own. How to insulate not yourself, your wife. Who is the object of the insulation?
Your wife.
Don't misunderstand. Immediately you say how to insulate yourself so that your wife does not. You are the other side of my sermon. You are the opposite. My sermon is how to insulate your wife. How to help your wife. How to assist your wife. How to bless your wife. That's it. So that she doesn't push you, instigate you, lure you into wrongdoing. We often tell youths to make sure they do not marry the wrong person. This is necessary and good. But the word of God goes beyond that. He counsels men on how to relate with their wives. The way the wives will not be able to push them into serious problems. Though the people of the world are seriously working against this today, just as they do to so many other ordinances of God. It is because God knows the peculiarity, especially with yiyato.
Ati yiyato.
Not ati yiyato. I take it again. Though the people of the world are working seriously against this, just as they do to so many other ordinances of God, it is because God knows the peculiarity, especially weakness of the woman folk that say that.
Nitori bo ti le je pa awon ara ye nse gidigidi lodi si eyi papa julo bi won tin se si opolopo asise olorun nitori pe olorun mo yiyato obirin.
That he made the man, irrespective of age or status, the head in every home.
In the
home. He told men to be very wise in dealing with their weaker wives. Weaker, not weak, weaker. That your translation is weak. My word is weaker. So I take it again. He told men to be very wise in dealing with their weaker wives. And he strongly told the wives to submit to their husbands. God did that because he's the one who made man. He made woman. He knows how he configured each of them. He knows how he programmed each of them. He knows what each of them is capable of doing. And these are written in so many places in the Bible. Women, agree with the word of God. Men, obey the word of God. It's only by that it will be truly well with you. What is the world doing today? World is trying to change all these ordinances of God. Making men to marry men like themselves. Making women to marry women like themselves. So one of the women will wear gown, the other one will wear coat. One of the men will wear gown, the other one will wear coat. They call themselves homosexual lesbians.
Some
even try to change it all together. They go to hospital to change their system. Destroying their vagina, replacing it with manhood. So that the woman can now begin to play the role of a woman. The woman playing the role of a man. The woman playing the role of a woman. They even try to create a bridge between the two. Some claim they are neither men nor women. So any day it feels like a woman, she prays her leave, she wear gown, and she goes out as a woman. Any day she feels like a man, she cleans the paint, and wears her coat and trousers, and dress like a man. And that is why in some places today, instead of 2 rooms in the toilet, you now have 3 rooms.
Now
it was done at the White House in America during the days of Obama. Obama, president of America, did a lot of evil by promoting gayness more than any of his predecessors. Donald Trump has been trying to reverse that.
Donald Trump ti gbiyanju lati yi eyi pada.
I know he's making some headway, but it's very difficult. They want to mix us together so well.
O fe lu wa po lu wa po
da po da. Neither male nor female. And meanwhile, they have Bible to support them.
Yes, ni won ni Bible to fin
gara. The Bible say in Christ, there is neither male or female. Greek or Gentiles. But when the Bible is talking, you must never isolate any saying of the Bible, any passage of the Bible, to build a doctrine. Because no passage of the Bible contains everything God wants to say about any subject. The revelations of God contained in the Bible are progressive. So to know what God is saying about gayness, start from Genesis to end in Revelation, bringing everything he says together, it's only that you'll be balanced in rightly dividing the word of truth. So the world is working seriously against it, but heaven and earth will pass away. The jot of the word of God will not pass away. God, knowing the way he configured each of these two sexes, he made the man the head and ordered him to apply real wisdom in relating with his weaker wife and command women to submit, not just to respect, submit. To submit is to come under control. Allow him to be the driver, not just of your house, but of you. So he said the man is the head, not just of the home, not just of the house, not just of the family. He said the man is the head of the woman, irrespective of status, educational background, age, whatever. The following scriptures will make us to understand. 1 Corinthians 11:3 says, But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Okay, just say it now. But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. There is a program there. To achieve that, though God is equal with God in all, Jesus is equal with God in all areas, he submitted himself to be under God. And man is expected to be under Christ. And the woman is expected to be under her husband. Anything different from that, it doesn't matter how many nations, governments, group of people adopt that, it is outside the will of God. In Ephesians chapter 5 verse 22, wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands. 1 Peter 3:7. Likewise, ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge. Knowledge of what? Chemistry. Biology. Botany. Zoology. Not even anthropology. The knowledge of the word of God. The knowledge you have gathered since you began to live together. And so, dwell with them according to knowledge. Give honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel. And as being here together of grace of life. That your prayers be not hindered. Take note. Even under the New Testament. Without wishes and wizards being involved. Without any demon or Satan himself being involved. The prayer of a believer can be hindered. And what the Bible says can hinder it there. Is the way you relate with your spouse. That means this is a serious matter. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm about to make a serious statement. If you are dosing, wake quick and hear. God actually expects husbands to treat their wives as fragile eggs that can break in one's hand, and even injure one, if not handled with care. Sister, wait, let me read the whole sentence. God actually expects husbands to treat their wives as fragile eggs that can break in one's hand, and even injure one, if not handled with care. There's a way you hold egg and it breaks. Come on. If it is the one with a very light shell, it may just crash your hand. If you hold the egg of some of these very big animals, such as sea tortoise, such as python, such as some of these big bears. If it breaks in your hand, it will shook your hand, blood will come out. So God expects every husband to treat his wife as a fragile egg that can break in one's hand and even injure one if not handled with care. I've finished my introduction. My sermon now. I have 2 points. Point number one. Bible revelations about wife instigations. Number two. What to do to prevent wife instigations. I hope I'll be able to preach it. I'm rushing really. I've sacrificed some important points. No. Explanation. The points I mentioned. Let's see. Bible revelations about wife instigation. Under that, we are looking at two things. Bible examples of wife instigation. The common result of wife instigation. From your Bible, you are told that Eve made Adam to eat the forbidden fruit and brought all the calamities we have in the world today on the world of Adam.
As of for we pay, if Adam je eso ti anikoma je
That is one of the beginning revelations we have in the book of beginning called Genesis. The Bible tells us in the book of Timothy that the man was not deceived. It was the woman that was deceived. But she made her husband to follow her in that
area.
Men, get ready. Your wife can go into error. I've said it before. Can I say it again? Pray that your wife will not eat apple, satanic apple in your absence.
Apple
issue. In your absence. If she eats satanic apple in your absence, she will keep one for you. And if you are not careful, you will eat it and have the terrible consequence.
But
when God is coming, God is not going to start with her. God didn't say,
Eva.
He said, Adam. Where are thou? It was Adam that first said, I ate fruit. He says, so if there is wahala in my house, I'm the one to call. Man, you are the one to call. Women understand that. No, I didn't say they understand. I said they should understand. When God is coming to deal with your family, even if you are the starter of the problem, your wife will be the first to question. Your husband will be the first to question. And therefore, he needs to be careful. Sarah made Adam to go into polygamy. The descendants of the two children produced by the two wives, Sarah and Hagar, have always pursued deadly rivalry that has become a major problem to the world, not only then, but up till today. Though with very good intention, the wife of Isaac led her son to deceive his father and made the father to do the opposite of his original plan unknowingly. No. Listen, I know it's lengthy. God will help you.
Amen.
Though with very good intention, go on. The wife of Isaac led her son to deceive his father. And made the father to do the opposite of his original plan, unknowingly. Men. The one. A woman does not need to have the spirit of witchcraft to exercise great power over you. Some people say women have seven powers. Head, eyes, lips, buttock, and so on. They have always said, as you mentioned, the seven.
Go and start with the rest.
Man, women has power. The promiscuous wife of Potiphar pushed him into treating his faithful servant Joseph very badly. And this must have brought great God's displeasure that was not necessarily recorded in the Bible into the life of Potiphar. The wife of Moses,
I am Moses,
though a priest's daughter, made him to go alone to Egypt to face all the terrible challenges he faced before being able to bring the children of Israel out of captivity. The wife of Samson was actually a real enemy for Samson, who prepared him to be captured and destroyed by enemy, collecting payment for that. Solomon's wife.
Aya Solomoni.
Solomon's wife.
Iyawo Solomoni.
Push him into idol worship.
O ti sinu iborisha.
Loss of his kingdom.
O padanu ijoba re.
And terrible divine displeasure.
I wu ni Olorun o si.
Let me read Nehemiah. You know all the scripture. Time will not permit me to read them. Nehemiah 13:26 says.
Nehemiah ori ketala ise.
Did not Solomon king of Israel sin by these things? Yet among many nations was there no king like him, who was beloved of his God, and God made him king over all Israel. Nevertheless, even him did outlandish women cause to sin, wisest man among men. Outlandish women push him into terrible problem.
Solomon ni oba Israeli ko hadeshe nipa nkan wonyi be ni laarin orilede pupo ko si oba kan bi ohun ti Olorun re feran Olorun si fi je oba ni ori gbogbo Israeli.
That the New Testament does not so much talk about women problems in the church is not an evidence that such problem did not exist. But this was in line with the fact that the New Testament is more concerned with the spiritual lives of believers. Since the Old Testament scriptures contain the examples that can guide believers on how to follow the instructions in the New Testament, nevertheless, the New Testament sees talk about how the wife of Herod pushed him to kill John the Baptist, a minister of God, contrary to the will of Herod. How the wife of Uriah joined him and possibly made him to lie in the church and die prematurely, and thus made their children orphans.
Bi aya Uriah se darapo pelu ki o si mu won paro si ijo won si ku lai.
Ananiah, I beg your pardon. Not Uriah. Thank you.
Bi aya Ananiah se darapo pelu ki pelu re o si mu ki o paro si ijo o si ku lai sojo bo ti le je won si so mo won di alai ni baba ati alai ni ya.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the New Testament, we don't have too much of the evils women put their husbands into. But nobody should say the New Testament doesn't see the problems are there. It was not mentioned, just like naming ceremonies are not mentioned. Christian marriage are not mentioned. So many other physical aspects of Christian life are not mentioned. So, we are not sure if it was no women problems that made Saul Paul, to do the unusual, living without a wife. Surely, it was not just to be able to preach the gospel. He's supposed to have married, or possibly he was once married before becoming a gospel minister. Nobody should say Paul should be a celibate because he wanted to be free to preach the gospel. At the time he was preaching the gospel, he was already a matured man who's supposed to have married. Who knows if he was even married, but decided to live without a wife because of conjugal problem. What is the common result of wife instigation? One of the greatest ways women instigate their husband is by pushing them into all kinds of wrongdoings and problems, such as the following. Polygamy. Some men marry more than one wife because their wife pushed them to it. They will have stayed with one wife. We won't have the story of pastor's wife.
Ati ni itan awon iyawo olusagutan.
Who is it? I'm not of age, yo.
Ani mo ti dagba o.
So you cannot have fun with me.
O le ba mi lo.
Anytime you have fun with me, I used to die in night, wake up in the morning.
So ba ba mi la sepo mo ma ku.
There was a solution. The mama.
Mama.
We now lure young girls into their apartments.
Awon omo kekeke wonu ile won wa.
And make their husbands to be fornicating with them. Pastors, why would they doing? Would they giving them clothes, give them money?
Mommy,
Rasha, mommy, Rabata for me. Mommy, told you me. Mommy, so school for me. When in reality, mommy is hiring them.
Mommy,
is it terrible? Terrible. In the villages, it's common for women to marry young girls for their husbands. So that men, if you don't insulate yourself, you may find yourself in such a problem. So you need to insulate your wife, rather, not yourself now. Your wife, in a way that can never happen. You say, how do I insulate my wife? I will get there. The real sermon is at the tail end. Just like my introduction was so elongated. All this explanation are elongated. The real thing I want to say is that the tail end. If you don't get to the tail end of this message, you will only hear jargons. Adultery. Women actually begging their husbands to marry another
one.
Some women push their husband into abnormal spending. The money they should use to train their children. The woman will push the husband, they use it to buy a shoebi. Men, don't kill your wife. That is how most women think. Women don't think that way. If you are not a man, you will fail. God is not going to punish your wife, he will punish you. You say why? Your wife is behaving like a female. If you go that way, you'll be practicing a feminine. So women push their husband to run away from home.
I want you to see your common life to sacrifice.
She's nagging. She's always complaining. She's always a mom. She's always this. She's always that. Insulate your wife. Pastor, how do I insulate my wife? I will get there. You know, some women made their husband to beat them. I have had before. I can't remember. Don't ask me to tell you. I can't remember. But I had a woman told people that is when my husband beat me that my sense used to be correct. Don't ask me. I can't remember how to tell you, but I had it. And some men know. Until I beat her, she will not beat herself. If you beat your wife, heaven will beat you. Insulate your wife. How do I insulate her? Is that my fault? We'll get there. Some women made their husband to call them wishes. Because she behaved like a wish. Meanwhile, she's not a wish. Do you know that some women go to confess before prophet that they are obanje when they are not?
I won't be in me. One locker. You want to go holy prayer again? You want to come and
a woman told me that. You see, money or
corn?
I asked you, Charles, but I said, when did you do your wedding? She looked at me as if I didn't know what I was doing. But I knew she didn't have anything like that. I said, okay. When did you do your wedding? Don't be like that. It's like, but I get a call. She used to come to me in the night and make fun with me. And I said, the first time you knew you were having spiritual husband was when? He said, when the pastor came to our church to do special program, he told me I have spiritual husband. After that, the spiritual husband began to come to me to have fun with me in my dreams. When a woman says that, what do you expect the husband to say? Insulate your wife. Otherwise, she will push you into destruction. Some women push their husband to be saying bad things about them. If you hear the way some men talk about their wives inside public transport, in drivers' garages. You think he's talking about his greatest enemy in the world? Some men, women, make their husbands to push them into depression. Because of the way she's behaving. Husband said, if I want to drive her, Ogunso, I would not agree. If I want to marry another woman, they will say the Bible does not allow. I know what to do. She locked up himself in a cage that the wife cannot reach him. He's in the house. But it's like somebody who have traveled to Australia. Here the woman talk from morning till eternity. The man is saying nothing. In fact, it doesn't return home until the woman and the children are asleep. And we get to a time that the woman begins to do con. Doctor will say she's depressed. So women push their husbands to make them childless. A woman is looking for a child. Every time the husband wants to have fun with her, she's having stomachache, headache, neckache. Until the man will have an extramarital relationship outside. And reproducing children there. The woman will never know. Then they say we should come in the husband. I'm busy. He's not concerned. You know why? He's already having 3 children outside. You are the childless one. Some women push their husband into homosexuality. The originators of homosexual in this modern world are men that became fed up with their wives and then decided to do away with it. Female wives to marry male wives. Larry King of CNN in those days was the one that popularized gayness of a governor in the U.S. And the governor came with the 2 wives. The female wife and the male wife. They were having a girl. And the man declared to the whole world, I've been living a double life. I'm married to this, my female wife. But this boy is also my wife. Now I want to declare to the whole world, I'm no longer interested in my male wife. I want to go with my female wife. I want to go with my male wife. And while they were talking, the boy would be kissing. I said, Ayeti wo. I thought the world will end the second day. But since then, it has been gaining popularity. Some women push their husbands to reach. If your wife will not push you to that, insulate your wife. So women made their husband to make them lonely. The wife of a popular pastor in Lagos. Who recently died first?
Said,
long time. After you people were saying happy married life. The marriage had broken. But you people didn't know. I was living far away. In Europe. He is living in Nigeria. Sometimes he doesn't come out and was it 2 times or 3 times? Don't let me have my own. Let me use the word. He seldom come to Europe. But you people don't know. You thought we're happily married. You know why? There are other women satisfying the man in Nigeria. To the extent that the woman abroad did not really matter. Until they eventually divorced. A footballer. No. An athlete. I think he should be a runner. Was condemned for killing his wife. Oh, because he has not paid dowry, they call her girlfriend. But they've been living together as husband and wife. And according to report, the woman was in toilet one day. The man just went to the door of the toilet and sprayed the door of the toilet until the woman died inside. When he was arrested for killing his wife, he said, I thought she's on the bed. So when I heard sound inside the toilet, I thought it's an intruder that I enter. They later convicted him of killing the woman. So women have pushed their husband into making them to commit suicide. Every time a wife commits suicide, something is wrong in that relationship. I don't have enough time, children of God. Let me quickly go to how to prevent wife instigation. I have 3 points. Hey, I have 10 minutes left. Less than 10 minutes. How do I do it? God, have mercy on me. There are 3 things. What to bear in mind. What the Bible teaches. My personal counsel. No, I will stop. Let me stop here. This other part,
if packaging,
I'm fearing if I rush it.
What
okay, let me make it rush. Maybe another day I will preach it fully. What to bear in mind? Quickly. Know that though it is necessary for a man to marry the right woman, the right way, and at the right time, this does not automatically insulate you against all the problems of wife or wife can create for husband. That you marry the right person, the right way, at the right time, does not mean your wife will not create you problem. No, your wife will create you problem. Know that one.
But that you pay both the shape attack if you are lati fe obirin to to lona to to ati igba to to eyi ko da abobo bi pe ki yawo re ko ma ru o soke sinu isoro abi ko ma
a lot of men enter into serious problem because they have wrong expectation.
Opolopo okunrin lo wonu isoro nitori
they think that since they marry Christian, they marry in my pattern church, there can never be any problem. When you come for post-wedding counsel, the first thing you will be told, if you come to me, this marriage will produce problems. When we want to glorify it, we call it challenges. Number two, know that like we have earlier discussed, both good and bad women are capable of creating serious problems for their husbands. Therefore, never think of divorcing your wife because she creates you problems. Good women create problems for their husbands. Was if not a good woman, when she gave her husband fruit, what was the consequence? Was Sarah not a good woman? New Testament still call her a good woman. When she pushed Adam into polygamy. Was Sipora not a daughter of a priest? Who have always been living in the sanctuary. Calling pastor in life. When she behaved the way she behaved. All good and bad women create problems for their
husbands.
Know that most of the time women create problems. We men actually prepare them for it. By not remembering and taking into account their peculiarities, weakness, fragility, and treat them as if they are not different from men. Know that those some women are much better than others. No woman is totally free of woman peculiarity.
But mo daju pe bo tile je pe awon obirin kan san ja won kan lo ko si obirin kan rara to wa lai ni isoro ailagbara ti obirin.
If you replace your wife with another woman, contrary to the word of God, you will by and by discover that the new woman too has her own peculiar problems and shortcomings.
To ba ropo yawo re pelu obirin mi na lodi si oro Olorun nipo o se wa mo wi pe obirin yi na pelu o ni akanse.
That's why some people will replace and replace and replace and replace.
Ni yawo kan ma fi ropo yawo ropo yawo ropo.
A man actually replaced until she had 20, she had 51 wives.
Okunrin kan o ropo 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 ni ti to fe
yawo kokan le ni adota. 51 marriages.
O se pe yawo kokan le ni adota. O sha ropo
wo. When she wanted to do it the last time,
so ma se pe yawo to keyin.
She remarried the first wife.
Eni akoko to fe lo wa pada lo fe.
Realizing that all the 50 that came in between were not better in any way. The problem the new wife may create may even be the time the Bible will not allow you to complain about. Getting sick often. Or carrying a deadly disease. That should even translate to your body. You marry a wife that is stubborn. You throw her away. You marry another one. Before you know it, she infects you with AIDS. Even if you throw her away, where do you throw your AIDS? Know that if you cooperate with God, He will give you the grace to cope with whatever problem your wife may create for you. Know that women think differently from men. Never expect your wife to see things always the way you see it. Many times you need to pray God to make her see what you are seeing. Because of their composition. Many things you say, woman, don't you know that if this child go to school, we pay this one, we do this one, you don't buy that gele, it will be better for us. And the woman is telling you that this gele, you say I shouldn't buy. How can you be so wicked? You say I shouldn't buy gele. Women are always buying gele. Women, did I not beg you before I start the sermon?
No, you
shame
your
banking. Me, daddy. No, that women think differently from men. They desire differently from men. They plan differently from men. They spend differently from men. To live with a woman, you must be a man.
So, lati ba obirin gbe, o gboro je okunrin.
But if you behave like a woman,
no, man, she be obirin.
Most husband and wife that cannot live peacefully together, both of them are behaving like women. God have mercy on me. God have mercy on me. God have mercy on me. Oh Lord, have mercy on me. Oh Lord, have mercy on me. I'm about to say something. And I know women can kill me for it. But don't kill me, I beg you. Please. I'm your daddy. Go and check.
Hello.
You won't see any house where two women are living together that they don't have any problem. Two women.
Obinrin meji.
Two daughters.
Omo meji, obinrin meji.
Daughter-in-law and mother.
Boya,
they are the worst enemy. Hey, married by the same husband.
Abi obinrin meji to kon kan fe.
So you spoil women. Women are not bad. I'm only saying women should understand you.
Mo so pe ko yi ka wo obinrin kan ni awo okunrin ka loye yin ni.
So you people, you don't quarrel. We'll be preaching. I'm coming to preach the second part. Is there you women will clap for me? You can frown your faces now. But by that I'm sure. I'm very sure. Very sure. Very sure. You will clap for me. Because I'll be preaching truth. I'll not be preaching like a man. I'll be preaching like a man of God. What the Bible teaches. Everyone hearing this need to learn how to cooperate with her husband as he tries to do what the man is supposed to do. You follow some of the things the Bible teaches. If a man wants to insulate his wife against leading him to error. I'm not reading the scriptures, unfortunately. You know what? I promise you. Within the next 3 months, I'll make this a booklet. Then it will be in your hands. Amen. You are to marry just one wife. Any attempt to get more than one can lead you to suicide. Genesis 2:24 says that. Follow your God more than your wife. However important your wife is. Deuteronomy 13:6 says, even if it is the wife of your bosom that bring wrong counsel, humbly reject it. Luke 14:20 says, if you don't hate even your wife also, you cannot be my disciple. The same thing with Matthew 19:29. No, Jesus is not teaching you error. Is he saying that you must follow your relationship with God more than your relationship with your wife? Don't allow your relationship with your wife to destroy your relationship with your God. Have authority over your wife. And my wife will not obey. Obey God. God will make her to obey you. Treat your wife with respect, care, and wisdom. Love your wife genuinely. Sincerely. That's how to insulate her. I will need to repeat this. Rushing it will not work. Let me just finish this and draw the microphone. Because I need to explain it. Because this is the core of the message. To insulate her. Love find the way that she will know my husband really loves me. Treat her as part of you. That any attempt to separate her will amount to a committing suicide. Always rejoice with her. That may be very difficult. But that's the demand of God. Be satisfied with your wife. Don't desire another woman. Be faithful to your wife. Then stay glued to her. Plan your life with your wife. Plan it with her. And what is my counsel? See your relationship with your wife as a permanent one. Do not expect from your wife beyond her ability. Physically, spiritually, financially, sexually. Do not compare your wife with any other person. Every woman has her own frailties. No, you must relate with your wife with openness. Not everything you know you will be telling your wife. If he tells you everything, he will create a problem. There are things I don't tell mommy. You're a bad pastor. You think when you discuss your family affair with me, I will go home and tell mommy. She knows I won't tell her. And there are things I don't expect her to tell me. I don't even want to hear. You say what? What I saw, I must read. So if I refuse to tell her something, she should refuse to tell me something. And I'm not bothered. You say, what do you refuse to tell your wife? The complaint of your relatives about her. Don't tell her. That's how to insulate her. Your mommy is complaining. Your sister is complaining. Your brother, I'm going to preach this aspect. I want to draw the but I will come back to preach. Let me just outline it because of those who will not come across the second part. Your consecration that she may not approve. So, do I have such? If Abraham had told Sarah,
see, Abraham will ask for Sarah,
I'm going to sacrifice Isaac, there will be katakata in that house. I'm teaching you Bible. Do not effort.
never compete with your wife.
Women spend the money in the house.
In the kitchen when you are doing wedding. Oh no, move mama. In my village, when you are doing wedding, oh lo birima, oh wo, lo birima, oh wo,
money.
Women, hood is synonymous with kilakwe. Money hood you like pay? Okay. Oh. Do not compete with your wife. She's not your competitor. She's your baby.
Baby.
Your wife is not your competitor.
Yawo re ki se ni ton ba fi gagbaga.
Your wife is your baby.
Yawo re baby re ni. Baby re ni.
Learn to always know.
Ko lati ma fi gbagbo
koko. And make available.
Ko si je ko wa ni rowo
to. Whatever will make her happy.
Ohun ko ke ma munu re dun.
That's how to insulate her.
Ki o se le dabo bo niyan.
Women cooperate more.
Awon okunrin ma so opo.
When they are happy.
Nigba ti won ba dun.
Anything you know she would like. You may not have money for Oma Jeep yet. But you have money for Sawama.
That is Sawama.
Apple. So should I be bribing her? Any man who does not learn how to bribe his wife will never enjoy his own life. That's comfortable culture. Any man who does not learn how to bribe his wife. We never enjoy his life. Young children here, when you are learning how to become an adult, so one of the things you learn is how to bribe your wife. So, women, pastor, so we are bribery. This is bribery without corruption. Learn to always answer our questions, which are often many. Don't use question to answer a question. You'll be in trouble. Where are you coming from?
Oshodima.
Don't say, where did I tell you in the morning? You'll be in real
wahala.
I serve you until they tell you. I don't get there since 1976. Where she said, where are you coming from? Oshodi, 2 feet man, here. If you don't say Oshodi man, she will cool down.
Oshodi man.
My wife will not hear this one.
Yeah, we'll be going.
If I'm going out of this yard, sometimes I've not told mommy. Oh,
it is for
mommy. Yes, what
about?
Do, Mati, daddy. Do. Hello.
Hello.
Mommy, I'm going to Molanos. Ibafo.
Mommy, I'm going
you
to
know our question. Don't let her hear. She has one more.
Are you still in the compound? Or you have moved outside the compound?
If you are deserving, man, we are not to match his daddy's
house. I told you that. Don't move out to
our little gate.
We are the gates, man.
Okay. She will teach you by
a man. It's not too dark. Don't be late.
You see that our tone will change.
I
know my limitation.
What do you want me?
Immediately I say, we are still at the gate.
But we're letting the gate.
I will get my license to go.
Say,
my mama, they control you.
And you say, mama, don't daddy.
Everybody say hi. Say hi again. Say hi once more. Deliberately make your wife feel secure. Don't let her think that you can ever drive her. Don't let her suspect you for extramarital relationship. Don't ever let her suspect you have bad plan for her.
Do.
Not always sissy. Discipline yourself. to treat all our relatives as your own relatives, parents, siblings, others. Learn to overlook most of our problems. There is no how you can do that, she will not create you problems. His wife, where is she? She's a good woman. I know she's a good woman. But if Ayola will tell you the truth, Ayola ma gbo, mo ko lodo baba. English. Talos English here. I feel like that. I know what me and baba discuss. About grandma. Don't tell baba Legu. I know what Baba Legu and myself discuss about mama. Every woman create problem for their husband. So all women are bad. As women, they will tell you all men are bad. Our configuration are not the same. You know what to do? Let overlook. I plan to preach a sermon. The greatest antidote for family problem. One of these days I'll preach it. It has been in my heart. I'm not fully prepared, but it's in my heart. The greatest antidote for family problem. You know, I wrote it in Yoruba. Amojukuro. That's what I wrote in my iPad. Amojukuro. Never. Confess anything in another man's wife. Just as the woman, your woman, brother, just as that woman you may confess has some things your wife don't have, your wife surely has some goodness that that woman does not have. It doesn't matter how bad your wife is. There is something good in her that is not in that other woman. You need to acknowledge it. Appreciate it. You know what you will do? You will be insulating her. She will create a problem. You live your life in what? In peace. Not in pieces. Who have I offended today? Women, forgive me. I will preach about men very soon. Stand up and let us pray. Thank you, Father, for your word. Bless it in our hearts. Cause it to do us good. That all our days we remember this truth, and the devil will not be able to push us into any error. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray. Bring out your offering. Bring out your tithe. Hold the two in different hands to save time. Your offering, your tithe. Bring the two out. You know what you do? I've spent your time along with my own. Still, I did not finish my sermon. Okay, who is in charge? You. Who is in charge? Come now. All right, to show the money. Just pray on the two. Then offering, they drop in the offering ball. Tithe. Don't carry your tithe to go. We need your money.
Shall we all stand up as we bring in our tithe and offering? If you have your tithe with you, can you just step outside, please? If you have your tithe with you, can you step outside? Or if you have dropped it to the during the week, or you have transferred it, can you just come to the front? Shall we pray? Father, we bless you. Thank you for how you have been supporting us financially, in our work, in our business. You are the great provider. Out of what you have provided for us, some of us have brought our tithes. Some of us have paid our tithes during the week. Father, we pray that you accept them in the name of Jesus. The entire church has also come with their offering. in appreciation of what you have been doing for us, in honoring you, in being our God. Accept everything we have brought to you in the name of Jesus. Bless our bosses. Expand our the source of our income, and all this one we have brought unto you, let them be useful to the work of the Lord. Thank you, Daddy, because you heard the Lord. In this church, raise great men of God that will be able to support you with money. Raise great men, captain of industries, among our youths, among our children. Thank you, Daddy, because of it. In Jesus' name we pray. Our God is great. The tithes are my left hand side, my right hand side, and the one at the back. Why we also drop our offerings around us. God bless you.
The big boss.